All right, guys, today I wanted to shoot a video talking about the top bladesmith content creators, knife maker creators out there. I thought it'd be nice for anybody who was interested in getting to know some good information about knife making and some tips and tricks that this would be a good place to go. First of all, let me just give this disclaimer. I'm a beginner knife maker. Although I started making knives when I was 15, there was a long break, and I've only made about 10 knives total to date. So the reason I bring this up is I do not want you guys to think that I am an official authority on this, or that you should respect my opinion above anybody else, other than the fact that I am just passionate about the craft, and I want to help you guys out.
Came out too. This mosaic is just so cool looking. The balance point is about 6 inches in front of the guard, which is exactly where I was wanting it.
4.5 months. It took longer than I expected, but
what people perceive the product that we make as art, that is, it's absolutely brilliant. But we are not artists. We're craftsmen.
I made this extremely historically accurate sword after 126 hours of studying the ancient art of feudal Japanese swordsmithing. Contemporary bladesmiths have been trying to recreate period pieces like this one for years, but have missed some.
I wanted to do the etch because I did 3 rounds in the gator piss and it just really wasn't etching that well. I really think it's because of the cold, or maybe the surface finish just wasn't good enough or clean enough. I'm certain it was some sort of user error, because last time I used the stuff, nice. I loved it. So.
I think the reason it gets so shiny is just because we've removed any of that real fine surface dust on there. But I am happy with that. That's how I want a handle to be.
The actual grooves and everything, the texture matches up. It turned out real nice with the black micarta pins. And then of course, this nice Brut de Forge, kind of like kukri.
First to say that perfection is not attainable, but that's still the goal for each creation.
Do you need to make that piece as well as what you're making if it's only ever going to be in a display case?
This is exactly the same type knife of that blade that we were just looking at. When it's cleaned up, the scale is gone. Now this has been heat treated, of course.
Every single project starts with cleaning up my steel. So what we're going to do for this dagger is...
We're excited to introduce to you
the brand new Speedgoat 2.0 knife.
Hey, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. I included all the links to all of the knife makers and their channels, and I think the videos that I found pretty educational and interesting. Let me know what you guys think. Hopefully this got you guys where you needed to get to for some good education.